What is a concussion anyway? Well, it's sort of like your brain getting shocked with a stun gun. It doesn't cause any damage that you can see with a plain x-ray or even a CT scan of the head, but there's some changes that occur. Think of it like pulling a muscle. You've pulled your brain muscle. So people may say, I'm dizzy, I see spots, I have a headache, they may even vomit. When you have sort of those behavioral things that have occurred, you have to think concussion first. What are the five things you think about when you think about concussion? And whether it's a child or an adult, you need to recognize it. The second thing is that child or adult needs to be pulled out of that activity. The third thing is you need to get checked out. There's sideline tests, there are other maneuvers that you can do to figure out if somebody has really been concussed. And the fourth thing is monitor the resolution. So either sitting in an office, sitting on the sideline, quickly get it done. And then the last thing is seek medical attention. How do we treat a concussion if we're a family member or a close friend and we're trying to help a friend or family member out? You need to be that advocate for them and make sure that they have what they need. So you want to make sure that they are comfortable, they're not being agitated. There's really nothing that's going to speed up the process. You need to just give it time and follow the recommendations of not only your doctor, but even the trainers who are well-versed in these types of things, and they can tell you when to get back on the field to play. Some of the top misconceptions about a concussion are, if you don't lose consciousness, you can get back in the game. If you don't lose consciousness, you can go back to the job site. If you get hit again with the same or even less of a pressure, your mind may take it even worse. The brain is primed to react more violently to that second hit. I think you need to understand that and make sure that you're out of that activity. Understand that doctors and healthcare workers are not trying to hurt you, and they're definitely going to keep you out of harm's way. But they want to make sure that you are as stable and as healthy as possible to live a long and productive life.